First truth, Hindu civilizational nation is under siege. It is getting destroyed. It is barely alive. It's in ICU. The one and only purpose of Kailasa is to revive Hindu civilizational nation. 800 years of brutal wars and 200 years of extreme brainwashing. Even Hindus have started believing something is wrong with the Hindu civilization. And Tamilians are brainwashed heavily that they are not part of Hindu civilization. Lingayats are brainwashed heavily that they are not part of the Hindu civilization. Nagaland tribes are brainwashed heavily that they are not part of Hindu civilization. Buddhists are brainwashed heavily and made to believe they are not part of the Hindu civilization. Sikhs are brainwashed heavily and made to believe they are not part of the Hindu civilization. Fundamental principles of Sikhism is to protect Sanatana Hindu Dharma. To protect Hinduism, Sikhism was created, the founding fathers of Sikhs. Their vision is to protect Hinduism. Jains are made to believe. Jains are brainwashed. They are not part of Hinduism. They understand? Every Jain tradition worships Ganapati and Padmavati. Every Jain tradition worships Ganapati and Padmavati, Lakshmi. Every Vaishnavite tradition worships Ganapati. Every Shaivite tradition worships Lakshmi. Unfortunately, too much of wrong ideas and brainwashing is happening to break the Hindu civilization. Listen carefully to these statements. These are warning for all the Hindus. First, Hindu civilization is under attack, under siege, in ICU. Hindu civilization is in the intensive care unit. First statement. Second, whenever a Hindu is diluted or converted, you are not only losing Hindu civilizational nation, you are losing Hindu territory nation also. World map is not eternal, as you Hindus are made to believe. Hindus are brainwashed to believe world map is eternal. Every 3 years, world map is changing. Hindus are not even realizing that the next world map change is going to shrink them more. Last 200 years, see the history. Last 1000 years, and now you lost 80% of your land. Not only 80% of your civilizational nation, 80% of your territorial nation is also lost. Last 200 years to now, you lost more than 90% of your civilizational nation and more than 90% of your territorial nation. Understand? Now, you have only one territory, Kailasa. That also I got it as Bhiksha. From different countries, I begged and got small bits and pieces of land here and there, sympathy, from their sympathy and compassion and love, they gave as a bhiksha. That small few pieces of land, In some place we got with autonomous status. In some place we got with nominal sovereignty. I am stitching all those few bits and pieces which I got from various corners of the world, in remote corners of the world, in remote islands, in various corners of the world, I got these few bits and pieces of land, Bhiksha, Bhudana. With that, now I am stitching this Kailasa nation, trying to make it as United States of Kailasa, legally stitching all of them and bringing them all under one legal entity and United States of Kailasa nation, with lots of hard work, literally lots of hard work, and among the persecution, amidst the persecution I am facing, the persecution attempts, death threats, assassination attempts, lawfare, defamation, cyber bullying, among all this, I got few bits and pieces of lands in my begging bowl, which I am stretching and stitching properly and making, forming this United States of Kailasa.